Hey y'all, it's Steve, Hobo with Wood, and this is going to be a short video on why your resizing slots and tabs just isn't working. It's going to be a short one, so don't go anywhere. Okay, boys and girls, so I'm getting ready to pull out and head to East Peoria, Illinois for the LightBurn experience. And so I'm not wearing my Hobo with Wood shirt, but it is me. I'm Steve, Hobo with Wood. I don't have the shirt on, but I hope you still recognize me. In the last 7 days or so, I have been just slammed with multiple people asking how come they can't get their slots and tabs to resize. There's something wrong with my file. It won't work. Well, and if you're one of those persons that I've helped, one of those people, I'm not singling anyone out because you're not the only one. There have been a bunch of people in the last week who have reached out, can't get this working. And they've said they've watched my video several times and following the video, and they just can't get it to work. So I went back and watched the video again and realized, well, I didn't mess up, but I didn't specify certain instructions that I thought were didn't need to be specified. But apparently they do, because a bunch of people have been having this problem. So I want to open this file in LightBurn, and this is the file from LaserMaker's Realm. This is the free file that I shared, the game box penny drop, and it's a game box that you it's a gaming box. You start with a handful of pennies, two or three of you, however many you want, and you take turns rolling a single die. And whatever number it lands on is where you place your penny. The penny will only sit on top of 1 through 5, but the penny will drop through number 6. And if you roll, and you say you roll a 3, and there's nothing on 3, well, you place your penny on 3 and it sits there. Next person rolls, they roll a 2. Okay, and they have a 2. Next person rolls, they roll a 3. Well, they can't put a penny there because the penny's already there, so they have to take that penny, and they have to clear the board. They have to take all the pennies. The first person to lose all their pennies by placing them all in number 6 is the one that wins. And they get to win. They get to keep the whole box. As far as all the pennies in the box. They become rich, and they can retire. But this design, I don't know if you play with Kerf or not, but I've been playing with Kerf and getting really super tight fits, you know, no glue at all in this. But you got to, you things you can't, you don't want to do with the kerf in LightBurn. You don't want to save the file with any kerf in the layer, because if you save the file with kerf on that layer, it will corrupt that file. So don't do that. If you have internal cuts, like this, where I've got cuts that are inside here, you don't want to add any kerf to this because then your penny may not drop through number 6. The bottom piece attaches the same way with internal slots instead of the external out on the lip. You don't want to add any kerf to those either. So let's take a look at this file in LightBurn, and I'm going to show you what I did to keep that from happening, and why isn't your resizing slots and tabs working? So let's jump into LightBurn. I'm going to open up the same file that you would be downloading from LaserMaker's Realm. And the file comes in just like that. And what you'll notice immediately is there are 3 layers, 4 counting the toolpath. But these internal slots that are on the base and the internal slots for the pennies, they're on a different layer all on their own. They're on the blue layer, the 01 layer. That way I can add kerf to the primary cut layer, the double or the O2 layer, my red layer, and not have to worry about it putting kerf where I don't want it. So if you've downloaded this file and you're like, wait a minute, why are these on different cut paths? Well, that's why they're on different cut paths. I can add kerf to the red layer and not the blue and not have a problem. The tool paths are on here because that is where I felt like the artwork needed to be centered up in order for it to look best whenever you engrave the box. Instead of centering it, because in fact, we'll take and we'll delete. Actually, we don't even have to do that. Select the artwork, hold your shift button and select the entire thing and tell that artwork to center, and it moves it up. And that's because it's putting it in the center between the top of those tabs and the bottom of the box here. And when I engraved it that way, it just didn't look as good to me. So I decided I'm going to put it here in the center of this toolpath. And I just felt like it looks better. So if you get this file, that's why those toolpaths are there. These just need to be centered in, actually, there's a toolpath in here as well. You can just barely see it right there. There's a toolpath there. It's doing the same thing. That way they're centered at the same height as these. But now let's talk about the slots and tabs and why they're not working for so many folks. If you select the entire thing and you come up here to Tools and you resize slots and selection, it's going to open up a menu. Now, the first problem that a lot of people have, and I do say this in the video, is you have to ungroup everything. But if you open this menu, before you mess with any of your sizes and thicknesses, look right down here. In fact, this should be probably up top because it takes priority over everything. You want to look, these are where your warnings are at. It's telling you your selection contains the following unsupported items. It has grouped shapes and shapes that are not paths or rectangles. Well, it's not, if they're grouped, a lot of my stuff is, then it's just not going to work. So you have to ungroup it first. And if that is the case, then that should be the first thing you see, not hidden down here in the bottom of the menu. So now let's ungroup everything. So everything's selected and we're just going to ungroup it all. Select it all again and go back into the resize slots and selection. Now you still got a warning down here because it's telling you the shapes that are not paths or rectangles. Well, that has to do with the text and the artwork. That's irrelevant. Now we need to change our slot depth and our tab height and our slot width because we have the internal pieces as well. Now you don't want to change the slot width on your pennies. So that's something you want to be cautious and be aware of with this file. But why isn't it working for so many people? Well, in my previous videos, up until now, this one is the first and all the future ones will have it too. You have to enter the old material thickness. Here you see it's already recognizing those. Well, that's just because I've got my tolerance level set so high. And that's kind of why I have my tolerance level set so high. I haven't gone and measured these. I don't know what the slot width is. So I didn't know what to put in here for the old material thickness. But if you, and most, 99% of you, when you open this up, it's going to have a 0.01 tolerance. And a 0.01 tolerance isn't going to see anything unless you have the exact measurements in there practically. And let's cancel this and let's go look to get our ruler and go look at this slot depth. It's 2.5 millimeters. So now that I know what the depth is, I can go back to resize slots and selection, and I can put the tolerance to 0 and put in the old material thickness. This is what so many of you are not doing. I just measured it. It's 2.5 millimeters. Now, if we zoom in here and get my mouse over here and take a look, Now, I just put in 2.5 millimeters, but see how it's not seeing all of these? It's because the tolerance level is at zero. So these are not exactly 2.5 millimeters. So if you increase your tolerance, there I increased it by 0.05 millimeters, and now it sees them. Now, me personally, I will keep my tolerance level at probably about a millimeter, and you'd seen I had it at 2 millimeters when I opened it last time. But you have to input your old material thickness, and to determine what that thickness is on a design that you've imported from myself or from Etsy or anywhere else, you use your ruler and come up here and measure the height of one of those tabs or the depth of one of the slots. And here we see this was 3 millimeters. So it wouldn't have recognized those tabs at 2.9 and a zero tolerance. So resize, slots and selection. You have to enter your old material thickness. Then input whatever your new material thickness is and adjust the slot depths. Then you say okay, just come back and do your slot width and say okay, go back and do yours. And that's another thing I'm going to bring up at the LightBurn experience. I wish, like here, I need to adjust the slot depth, the tab height, and the slot width. And I wish you could go ahead and just select which ones of those you need to adjust and say okay. Because as it is now, you tell it I need to do slot width and we're going to change it to 2.78, say okay. Then you got to go right back in again, resize slot width, and say okay. Tools, resize, and tab height, and say okay. And there may be something in the programming that won't let them do that, but I wish that that was there. I wish you could do multiple adjustments at one time. And also, the ability to... Let's see here. Let's put it in inches and go into tools and resize slots and selection. Well, if you got it to this point, and priority matters. I've said that a million times if I've said it once. Priority matters when light burn. But sometimes you find yourself a little bit down the path and you're like, wait a minute, I should have done this first. Well, here it's in inches and I don't know what inches I want it to be. I need it in millimeters. It'd be nice if there was a button over here that you could toggle back and forth between millimeters and inches, just like they have it here. Right there is, we're in the ruler and we're in inches, but there's a button right here that you can switch to where you're measuring in millimeters, metric or standard. So they can do it. I wish that was in the resizing slots and selection. Wish you could do all those at one time instead of multiple inputs. I've got a whole list of things I want to see done or that I would like to suggest as far as, in my mind, it would make them improvements in the light burn. But that, guys, and again, if I have helped you this week, I am happy to do it. I'm glad I was able to resolve your issue. You were not the only one, or else I would not be making this video. I've had to have a handful of people has reached out to me just in the past couple of days that needed this exact solution because I did not say previously, you have to enter the old material thickness. So many people think that because I glazed over that, I didn't say it because I thought, well, it's on the screen. I know you got to enter it. Now, a bunch of people thought that it auto-detects what the slots and tabs are and the automatic height and width. And it doesn't. It's not that slick. And then plus two, if you've got multiple widths, like over here, these on the, go back to this one. I've got these internal slots for the pennies. They're one width, and they're nowhere near as wide as these. So there are designs that you would have multiple thicknesses or widths of slots, and so it wouldn't know what to auto-detect. So you have to tell it what to look for. And that, I do understand why you have to do it that way. So guys, I got to finish packing up. I'm going to hit the road. I'm going to take my time getting there. It's a 12-hour drive, and I'm going to do it in 2 days just because I can. Don't have to be in a hurry. I'm going to get there early. I'm going to get there probably Thursday, get set up. I'm taking the RV, and I'll get the rig set up and get a good rest and be ready to hit the ground running Friday when everything kicks off. We will see you live at LightBurn Experience. And until then, I'm Steve, Hobo with Wood, even though it doesn't say it. And I'll see you in the next video.